At the recent International Conference on Robotics and Automation, MIT researchers presented a printable origami robot that folds itself up from a flat sheet of plastic when heated and measures about a centimeter from front to back. Weighing only a third of a gram, the robot can swim, climb an incline, traverse rough terrain, and carry a load twice its weight. Other than the self-folding plastic sheet, the robot's only component is a permanent magnet affixed to its back. Its motions are controlled by external magnetic fields. This advancement is significant, particularly in the case of surgical tools, as it shows that tiny machines can be controlled remotely without needing to carry along electronic controls or their own power supply.
We have designed and built an origami robot that gets up and goes. In other words, the robot forms itself on the spot, accomplishes tasks, and then it disappears by degradation. The robot self-assembles using a folding process that is triggered by heating. After this, the robot can run along designated trajectories, it can carry objects, it can clear obstacles, it can swim, it can execute a variety of tasks. And when these tasks are done, the robot can recycle itself by dissolving its body into a liquid.
This is the first robotic device that completes a full life cycle from its birth to its death. Typical robots consist of electronic devices. Our robot is made based on controllable materials. This is the biggest difference.
The robot's body has embedded in it a small magnet, and this allows us to control the robot by programming a magnetic field. In other words, the robot has external programmable actuation.
Currently, the robot is controlled remotely by a person. We'd like to advance this robot and make it more intelligent such that it can make decisions by itself.
Origami-inspired robot designs have the potential to be faster, cheaper, and easier to fabricate than robots created using traditional manufacturing processes.
It is easier for such a system to be used closer to humans, such as in the human body. For example, you could regard this robot as a controllable drug capsule or a surgical tool which can be removed after its use in the body.
Can imagine ingesting these robots and then controlling where they travel in the body. And once they arrive at the correct location, they could form themselves into active instruments that can actually manipulate and help through the healing processes. For the short term, we see these robots as potentially extremely useful in inspection tasks because they are small and they can travel through very intricate, small, narrow pipelines that are difficult to inspect with today's technology.